This is the Google Nest Photo Max Pro Edition. I can't even remember the name of it. But anyway, this is a little tablet, effectively, a little screen that has a camera and a microphone that's always listening. And it shows you photos from your Google Photo library. And what I do is I bought a few of these for my relatives, sent them to them, and I have a shared, or had, a shared Google Photos album. And so when I wanted to share pictures of what my kids been up to with the grandparents, I just add photos to that Google Photos library and boom, it just works. But in the last few weeks, I've been on somewhat of a mission to kind of get rid of as much big tech as I possibly can, Google specifically. And now I have this. This is a cheap $100 Android tablet that literally just emulates what this does. So it's using Immich on the back end, and I will put a link in the description to the Immich project. Of course, this is a self-hosted Google Photos clone. And using this cheap $100 Android tablet, I can now basically replace Google Photos and give this as a Christmas gift to my relatives back in England so they can see what their granddaughter's up to. So that's what we're going to cover in today's video, how to set up the basics of ImmichFrame with an Android tablet over the ocean so you can give your relatives some Christmas cheer with Tailscale and ImmichFrame. Now I'm going to assume that you already have Immich set up. In fact, I'll put a link to the Immich timestamp in the self-hosted Getting Started Part 2 video I did a few months ago, where I showed you in depth how to set up Immich itself. If you don't want to watch that, I'm not going to go through step by step how to set up Immich itself, but as always, there are code snippets with this video, and here is how you set up Immich from scratch in a single compose file. So I'm going to assume that you already have Immich up and running, you have some photos, that kind of thing. You can see I've already got Immich on my tailnet at immich.velociraptor-noodlefish.ts.net. And so the next step for us is to spin up ImmichFrame. It's really simple. So a couple of things we need to do. Jump into the ImmichFrame directory in the code snippets repo. Notice this new way of configuring Docker Compose Tailscale serve config files. Usually I would have you bind mount these configs via a volume, but I found out a new trick this week where you can actually specify configs in a stanza like this as part of a Docker Compose YAML file, and then pass it through to the underlying container like so. So we don't need to bind mount any files for the ImmichFrame family Tailscale container anymore. All we need to do is make sure that we've got our varlib tailscale directory persisting so that when the container restarts, it remembers who it is. And then we need to generate an auth key for ourselves as well, of course, to authenticate this node to our tailnet. Same procedure as always, we'll go over to the Tailscale admin console, go to settings, click on keys, generate auth key, and I'm just going to click generate key. And this is going to allow us to authenticate ImmichFrame to our tailnet so that we can share it out with our family members later on in the video. So TS auth key equals, and then the value from the Tailscale admin console. Now the next thing we need to do is configure the ImmichFrame container itself. So we're going to grab the URL of our Immich instance on our tailnet, and this needs to be the full domain name that you would use to access the container remotely. So HTTPS also needs to be included in there. And you see I get this name here from my Tailscale admin console by going through here, finding Immich in the list, and then clicking on the dropdown and copying that value to my clipboard and pasting it into the YAML file right here. Now the API key, again, this is pretty straightforward, and this is actually covered on the ImmichFrame documentation itself, by the way. So if you look under here, API key, what is it, face.read or something? Yeah, here we go. The API key permissions that you need are listed here. There are 9 explicit values that you want to configure for the API key inside of Immich, so the ImmichFrame, which is an external application, remember, can't have the keys to the kingdom and do things you don't want. However, in the interests of brevity for video production, I am just going to go through and create a God mode API key that has access to everything. You should not do this. Do as I say, not as I do. I've given you the tools to solve this problem. I just don't want to make you watch me click 20 different buttons to get there. All right, so I'm going to paste in my API key like so, and now we're good to go. We just need to copy this file to our remote system. However, one thing I want to do before we get there is show you how to configure things like albums and people and images and that kind of thing. In the Immich documentation, there is a way to configure under Docker setup. If you look at the env example here, if you look for people, for example, you can list specific people. So that would appear in your image explore tab right here. You can also list explicit albums as well as exclude explicit albums as well. So let's just create an album. I don't know, I'm just going to select a few pictures here. Click on the plus button. I'm going to create an album here called Demo Album. New album. Yeah, here we go. And when I click on View Album, we need to take note of this string at the end of the URL right here. We don't put Demo Album, although that would be nice, into ImmichFrame, wouldn't it? We put this unique string of 3CBE, whatever. We put this string into our album's environment variable right here. This will display just that album on the remote side. So this is how you would control the specific pictures that your friends and family can see in on their image frames remotely. So, you know, you only want pictures of grandkid, you know, just only add pictures of grandkid to that specific album. And that's all that's going to show up on the remote side. Now we are ready to rock and roll. We are ready to go. There are some other things you can configure here, but I'll leave that as an exercise up to you to configure time and date to your preferences. Now I'm going to copy this whole file to my clipboard. I'm going to use the Tailscale VS Code extension right here, and I'm going to create a new directory on the remote host called ImmichFrame. And in here, I'm going to create a new file, and I'm going to call that one compose.yaml. And if I refresh, there we go. There is the file. Paste it in here. And then because I am prepared, I already have a terminal window back here ready to go. So now I want to jump into, what did I call it, ImmichFrame, and then just do a docker compose up minus d. And now if I do docker compose logs minus f, we can see that the Tailscale serve ImmichFrame Tailscale container is coming up. It's doing all of the Tailscale serve stuff that we asked it to do, hopefully. And now it's time to go and verify that it's actually working. So we want to go to our tailnet and look for the ImmichFrame family container that's just joined our tailnet. Click on here and copy this URL to our clipboard. Open an incognito window just to avoid any certificate weirdness. And everything appears to be working just fine. I had to refresh a couple of times in the background. The certificate weirdness that I talked about reared its ugly head. But you can see that we are now showing this demo album. And this is how ImmichFrame works. It's a very simple application, really easy, and a great gift for this holiday season. So now we have ImmichFrame working on our tailnet. You can see I'm connected to my own personal tailnet here. Well, my YouTube demo tailnet, at least. What if I wanted to share this with a grandparent or a friend or somebody else like that? Well, there's a couple of steps we need to do. First of all, we need to go into our machines page and give this node a tag. This is so that we can reference this in our ACL file so that we can share it with other people safely and securely. So let's jump back to the Tailscale admin console, click on access controls, and add in a new tag right here called, I don't know, family share. Further down in the file, we want to look for this grants stanza right here. Now your ACLs will probably look a little different to mine, but the idea is the same. Look for this grants stanza right here. And then add in these five lines right here. There'll be a link to a snippet for this ACL or this grants snippet. There'll be a link to that in the description down below. It's in the GitHub repo as well in this folder here called ACL snippet, by the way. Essentially, what this is doing is it's allowing us to use the auto group shared to give people on the remote tailnets access to devices on my tailnet on ports 443 and port 8080. This is essential for ImmichFrame to do what we want it to do today. So we'll click on save, and hopefully your JSON validation will work just fine. You can go through the visual editor as well if you want to sort of click your way to victory and do it over here. I just prefer the JSON editor, you know, different strokes for different folks, right? So now we're at the point where ImmichFrame fam is ready to be shared out, almost. We need to give it a tag first of all. So click on the three-dot menu over here, and then click on Edit ACL Tags and select Family Share. And so by virtue of giving that node that tag, that now means that when you share it with somebody else into another tailnet, out from your tailnet into theirs, they can now access ports 443 and port 8080. So let's see that in action, shall we? Let's share that from this tailnet, which is my YouTube demo tailnet, into my personal tailnet. So we have a shared link on our clipboard right here, and we can see that the website's working just fine. But if I go over here and change to my personal tailnet and try and refresh the page, we see that obviously instantly it stops working because there are no routes. It has no permission to get anywhere. So I'm going to jump over here to my other tailnet, my personal one, and add this node, ImmichFrameFam, from a tailnetscale. This is the link you would send to the grandparent, to a friend, to whoever. This is the link that allows you to add the image frame container that's showing you the images to your tailnet so that you can see those pictures too. I'm going to click on accept invite and we'll just give it just a second to reload. And now we should see that the image frame fam container shows up in our tailnet as a shared in device. And indeed, if we go back to the admin console of the other tailnet, you can see that I've accepted the invite and it's now also showing as shared out plus one. Interestingly enough, if I go to my personal tailnet, you'll see that I still get the same fully qualified domain name, velociraptor-noodlefish. So if I now try and load this page, it just works just like that, right? So now effectively what we could do is load up any device with Tailscale. In fact, let me just grab my phone right here and make sure that I'm logged in to Tailscale, of course. You can see here is my personal tailnet. I've got two tailnets on this device, but the remote person, you know, they don't need to worry necessarily about having your personal tailnet. Obviously, the whole point is for you to share image frame into their tailnet. So let's find that device in this list here. In fact, if I just search for the word image, there it is. We can see that Pangolin, which is the person who owns my demo tailnet, has shared in ImmichFrameFam. Velociraptor. So if we now go to Safari or wherever and paste that URL in, I'm going to turn off the Wi-Fi just so that I am connected over 5G, just to kind of prove to you that there's no trickery going on my local network here. It's all just literally happening over Tailscale, and press go. And we can now see the image frame is loading up on this device. It might take a minute because, you know, cellular connections take a moment or two to load files. But you can do all sorts of tricks with the phone and the tablets and stuff to make them sort of load these things automatically. So on iOS, for example, if you press the three-dot menu at the bottom and then you click on the share button and sort of scroll up a little bit as you do it, there's this option here called Add to Home Screen. And I can now open Image Frame as a PWA, like a web app. And so if I press on this now, it will load no matter what the network topology is between this device and your image server, your image frame instance, and it will just load up these images on the back end. How cool is that? Let's be real. No ports are open in your firewall. There's nothing exposed on the public internet. All you need to do is make sure that the grandparent or the friend or the family member has Tailscale installed on their device, which is completely free, remember. 100 devices and 3 users completely for free and will always be for free. And you don't need to open ports in your firewall or send them complex VPN configurations. You need to send them a link to add this node to their tailnet, as I showed you a few minutes ago. And then they copy that URL that they get in the Tailscale app into their web browser and then add it as a web app on their home screen, and they're done. You can get used iPads for, I think I saw like a second gen iPad Pro locally for about $120. I mean, the old tech, it doesn't need to be very performant in order to be useful in this scenario. And the older technology is really cheap. I mean, that Android tablet that I had in the intro on the bench over there, I mean, that cost me $120 on Black Friday last year. It's a Samsung, it's not important, but it's a Samsung Tab A10 or something like that. You really don't need much performance because all it's doing really is just showing a web page. On Android, at least, you can use something called Fully Kiosk Browser to use the webcam in the front of the tablets to like detect motion. So if your grandparents have, or family members, or even yourself, if you have concerns about leaving a tablet on 24/7, well, Fully Kiosk Browser will let you solve for that issue by using the camera in the tablet as like a motion detector. And there are all sorts of other creative solutions that you can do with this stuff. to kind of work around these types of problems. Because ImmichFrame is just a web app, I know I've shown you today on iOS and Android, but it will also work on the NVIDIA Shield TV on Android TV as an official Android screensaver. So your TV could literally be a giant picture frame and it will work the same. You can install Tailscale on that and do the same deal. It will work on Apple TVs as well. I believe there's an app for Apple TVs. It's just a really cool project. And it, for me, it sits perfectly at the intersection of technology, meeting the real world and solving real problems for people that they might have. This also has the added benefit of, well, it keeps everything local. All of these images now remain in my network. The only AI models that are going to train on them are mine, because Immich has face detection and object detection stuff for machine learning. And that's it. That's the business model. The open source project gets its kicks through supporters and things like that. And you can go and look at the Immich project and the Futo team over in, I think they're in Austin, Texas. They do a fantastic job. With Immich now being stable, you can start to really rely on this stuff to build long-term solutions like self-updating digital photo frames. Let me know in the comments down below if you found this solution useful, because this idea kind of hit me like a lightning bolt a couple of days ago. I'm like, oh, this is going to make the best video. So I'm just really thrilled to get to share it with you all on the Tailscale channel. And I hope you have a fantastic holiday period, great new year and all that kind of stuff. Huge thank you to you for watching all these videos all year long. And I guess until next time, I've been Alex from Tailscale.